The night that I discovered that I can sing with a lot of soul, someone said that I wasn't rocking enough. I remember sitting there and I was just thinking like, you don't think I'm rocking enough? There's that big high note at the very end of Lesson Hole that I just went for it.
Nobody should be Lesson
Hole. And I remember looking around and everyone's just looking like, and I think what that taught me was when you feel like you've hit a wall, just tear it down. I love creating things, whether it be something intangible as a song or a stool or a bench or a light or a whatever that is. I think every time I go in and write a song, the goal is just to write a great song. Through having the hits as a songwriter from Barefoot Blue Jean Night, Even If It Breaks Your Heart and Angel Eyes, I've learned that a song gets heard if it's supposed to. And a hit's not a hit unless people get to hear it. And that being said, I love writing songs because there's so many levels to it. One song can mean one thing to one person and mean completely a different thing to the other person, and they both love it. And I hope people, when they come to my show and when they listen to my records, they just feel a hope and something bigger than us. Even when life sucks, you know, someone out there cares for you and you're loved. 5 minutes before a show, I'm running around trying to find my in-ear monitors. And, you know, I think backstage, you're just standing there alone in the dark. And I always try to remember, like, it took a long time to get to this stage. Oh, I wanna be your Friday night, sweet ride, summertime, sunshine, barefoot in the moonlight. I've been out opening up for Eli Young Band and a lot of other artists on the road, and they don't know really who I am. I start playing Friday night and then they go, that's that guy? You know, and it's fun to be in that part of my career. I always make a point after a show right now to go out by the merch table and take a picture with somebody or sign something. And I just think about, you know, Garth Brooks and Taylor Swift and a lot of people that I respect on how they treat their fans. That's one thing they started out doing was meet your fans. For anybody to get on stage every night to where you might make a fool of yourself is pretty odd. So I'm glad that God allows me to be foolish enough to do this for a living. And I definitely try to pay attention to the words I sing and make sure they matter. I think this album's taught me to not be afraid to be me. Taught me to be aware of what I sing about and not be afraid of what instruments I put on a song or how big the beat is. Sometimes silence is loud, and sometimes loud it speaks to the quietest part of your soul. I'm not sure if I'll ever make an album quite like this first one. With the 11 songs on the album, I'll be proud to sing any one of those every night for the rest of my life.